on the electric company, the lady asks, is it...
Hi there. I'm standing on the corner of 5th and Main, where hopefully some very lucky individual is going to walk by and try Nutty, Crunchy, Munchy candy. The candy that is Nutty, Crunchy, Munchy, and definitely not great for your teeth. Oh, here comes somebody now. Excuse me, miss.
Huh?
Would you like to try Nutty, Crunchy, Munchy candy?
Oh, sir.
Well, go right ahead. Take a big bite. Okay, tell us, is it Nutty?
Definitely.
Is it also Crunchy?
Mm-hmm.
I'll assume that's a yes.
Yep.
And is it Munchy?
Yeah, without question.
Well, folks, there you have it. The person on the street says that our candy is definitely Nutty, Crunchy, Munchy candy.
It really is, folks.
It's also 15 cents.
What?
Well, I mean, what am I supposed to do with a used candy bar?
I only took one bite of it.
Did I force you to eat that candy?
I'll give you 2 cents.
25.
I ate one bite of it.
Hey, have you noticed something? The letter Y can have two different sounds at the end of a word. Like, for instance, sometimes it sounds like I, like in, shy. Huh? So, the sound of Y makes there is like this. I! That's right, you lux. Okay, now another thing you should notice is the letter Y, also at the end of a word, can make a sound like E, like in baby. Huh?
Right, baby.
Uh-huh. So the letter Y, in this case, makes a sound like this. E! Another klutz. He's right. Any questions?
I'm a funny guy. I'm a funny guy. I love to toss a pie. Get it in the eye. Don't know the reason why. Hey, I'm a funny guy. I'm a funny guy. Dee 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 dee. I'm a funny guy. Dee 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 dee. I'm head over heels. About banana peels. I guess I like to fly. Hey, I'm a funny guy. I'm a funny guy, dee 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 dee. I'm a funny guy, dee 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 dee. I'm a funny guy, dee 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 dee. Don't ask me why I'm funny, and don't applaud, throw money. I'm a funny guy, dee 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 dee. I'm a funny guy, dee 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 dee. I love a little squirt. It cools and doesn't hurt. That's why I'm really dry. Hey, I'm a funny guy. Oh, yeah. So when you're feeling teary, I'll try to make you cheery. If you find me dreary, I'll jump into Lake Erie. I'm a funny guy.
Bet you thought it was going to be tough to learn about the two sounds of Y, right? Just goes to show you, things are easy if you try, right? You keep watching for these two sounds now. I'm going to finish my book. The shark soon learned to play first base.
Silly. Silly. Silly.
Hey, 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 what do you say, Toon Goons? Yours truly, Mel Mounds here. I thrive on jive, so give me five. Glancing at the charts here, I see that our own short Circus are riding a bullet as they ask the perennial musical question, why? Here we go. Mates, why? They said it, not I. So good luck and goodbye. Ha ha ha! Out of sessions.
You know, when it really comes down to it, behind those shades, Easy Reader's really a good-looking guy. Yeah. Oh boy, there goes the set. Well, now old Easy's not just a good-looking guy; he's a bunch of good-looking guys. Dumb TV.
Now, wait a minute.
What?
There's no need to blame your TV set, madam.
No?
No, it's all part of the show.
Oh.
It's just a reminder to add that little S.
Yeah?
Yeah. Like that S in the word guys?
Yeah.
You see, whenever you see more than one of something, you add an S to it. That's if there's more than one.
Yeah.
And forget the S if there's just one guy.
Yeah.
Right. You keep watching for that little S. And, madam, thanks for the compliment.
Oh, my pleasure. You're not going to make my TV go haywire again, are you?
Oh, no. I promise.
Okay.
By now, this shark I'm reading about is ready to run for Congress.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Note. Notes.
Hey, come on, you guys, get your stuff together.
An S on the end can give you a clue that instead of just one, what you got is a few. An S on the end is good for a hunch, that instead of just one, what you got is a bunch. You want lots of me, well that'll depend on whether or not there's an S on the end. Crank, cranks, crank.
The
Be short, Circus kids. Have 5 seconds to read the next word they see. Can you read it before they do?
Kids!
Did you really expect us to mess that up?
I mean, it's the easiest word.
I'm afraid it's up to you.
It is?
Yes, you see, the British are coming.
No, I better set some extra places for dinner.
Paul, they're not coming to dinner. Huh? I'm afraid they're coming to attack us.
You're kidding. We better get out of here, then.
Well, that's, true. Well, we have a job to do, Paul. We have to warn the countryside.
Rather. Let's get out of here and warn the countryside.
Quiet. Now, here's my plan.
Oh, yes, we plan. We need
we
a plan.
We will wait in the steeple of the old North Church to
Cunning.
See if the British are coming by land or by sea.
Yes.
When we know, we'll signal you.
Ah, I gotcha. Rather. Good plan.
Paul?
Yes.
The signal will be one, if by land.
Yes, that one.
Two,
yes,
if by sea.
Yes, I think I have that. That's rather simple. That's one, if by land, that one there.
Yes.
And two, if by sea.
Right.
These two little devils over here.
Right.
All right. I think that's rather easy. One, if by land. Two, if by sea. One, if by land. One what? One what, Emery?
Lantern.
Ah.
I'll wave
one of those.
One lantern,
yes.
If the British are coming by land.
Yes.
I'll wave two lanterns.
Ah.
If the British are coming by sea.
Yes.
Now that's
rather.
One lantern by land.
Yes.
Two lanterns by sea.
Yes.
You got that now?
I think so, Emery. Let me see here. That's one lantern if by land.
Quiet.
Two lanterns if by sea.
Quite right.
That's one lantern, land.
Quiet.
Lanterns. See.
Quite right.
Very good,
yes,
chaps.
Yes.
Very good.
Now, Paul.
Yes?
What if you should see three lanterns?
Well, then they're coming by bus or subway, and they've decided to forget the whole thing. How should I know, Emery? You're the one making the plans here. He always makes the plans.
Mm-hmm. It means they're coming by land and by sea, Paul.
Those crafty devils.
Yes, they are.
Well, let me see. Let's see if I have this all together here. That's one lantern, if by land.
Quiet.
Two lanterns, if by sea.
Quiet, right.
And three lanterns, by everything, coming out of the woodwork, as it were.
By Jove, I think he's got it.
Very good, chaps. I'll see you there. Save me a place.
Paul?
Yes?
What if you should see no lanterns at all?
No lanterns? Well, then you forgot to pay the light bill or something like that. For this, I'm going down in history.
If you're so terrific, if I'm gonna be specific, if this kind of special word, if is a word that helps me dream with, if I imagine lots of things, no matter how strange those things may seem. If rocks were made of rubber, bicycles could fly? If city streets were city streams? If stars fell from the sky? If vacant lots were jungles? If kids were 10 feet tall? if I'd have no fun at all. If you're so terrific, if I'm gonna be specific. If is a kind of special word, if is a word that helps me dream. And if I imagine lots of things, no matter how strange those things may seem. If you make a difference, I'm a lucky stiff to have a magnificent if.
If it swims, we have it.
If it swims, we have it. Fish!
Hey, 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 wait a minute, guys. Where was the if in that section? No. This is the part about if. There wasn't no if in that film. Only fish, and I hate fish. This is the part about if. Right. Where? At the beginning? If it swims, we have it? There was an if in there? there was an if in there.
Hi, I'm here for Easy Reader, who's trying to finish his book. He told me to tell you that if you stay tuned and if you pay very close attention, you'll see more if. What's happening in the book?
The shark is eating Pittsburgh.
Oh, that's awful. I mean, eating Pittsburgh can give one indigestion.
Oh, wicked stepmother. May I ride with you to the ball at the palace?
Cool it, Cindy.
Okay. Oh, please, wicked stepmother, let me ride with you to the ball.
Don't,
but I want to go. I can taste it. I want to go
down.
Bed.
Well, maybe.
Maybe?
If,
you name it, wicked, you know you got it.
If you wash the dishes.
Wash the dishes.
And if you dry the dishes.
Dry the dishes?
And if you put away the dishes.
Put away the dishes?
Then maybe I will consider taking you with us to the palace for the ball.
Gotcha, wicked. If I wash the dishes. And if I dry the dishes. Now may I ride with you to the ball?
No.
No, but you said...
I said that if you did all those things, maybe I would let you ride with us. But I have decided against it.
Boy, maybe sure is a wishy-washy word. And I wouldn't give you 2 cents for if, either.
Where do you think you're going, young lady?
I'm going to the pumpkin patch to see if I can thumb a ride.
I am going to get that caterpillar. I am going to get that caterpillar. I am going to get that butterfly.
Hello, the electric company. Oh, you mean that you didn't understand what those, little marks meant when Hunter was speaking? Please, calm down. Don't shout at me. After all, I'm just a child.
Samantha, honey, let me handle this for you, okay? There's an area that where adults know how to talk to people. You know, it's okay. Got to do with tact and diplomacy, right? I'll handle it. You listen. See how I do. Yes, right. Wait, you see those little marks that you seen when Humpty Dumpty spoke? Yes, they are called punctuation marks. Let me put it this way, lady. You see that word, goodbye? Yeah. Now, if I just want to say goodbye nicely, then I just put a period at the end, like this. Goodbye. Yeah, goodbye. Right. If I'm not sure I want to say goodbye, then I put a question mark at the end, like this. Goodbye? Goodbye? Let me tell you. Yeah, look. Now, if I really want to say goodbye, and I feel strongly about it, then I put an exclamation point at the end of it, like this. Goodbye! Yeah, you got. Listen very carefully to this now, all right? Goodbye! There's a way to deal with people. You know, you gotta have a little class. You know what I mean? Little patience and be nice. You know what I mean?
Strike one. Strike two. Strike three. Are you set?
I am set.
Are you set?
I am set.
Are you set?
I am set.
Are you set?
Stay on with it, will ya? How many times you gonna ask me that? Yeah, I'm set. I'm ready to run. I wanna run. I'm gonna run. Now let's go. I'm set.
Okay.
Are you set?
I'm set!
Then why didn't you run?
I'm too upset.
Walk right in and
And now you sing along with us. You know what I mean?
Children's Television Workshop.